Lezhny, who will lead them out. Sergei Grankin, their captain, veteran player, Olympic gold medalist in 2012 and a 2008 bronze Olympic medalist as well. He sets the tone, he is the setter. Ivan Yakovlev is the beast of a blocker. No one better in the competition. Fedor Voronkov, a young outside hitter. Dmitry Shcherbinin getting the start today at the middle, with Pavel Kruglov coming in. And the libero today is Yevgeny Andreev, a youngster. The interesting switch-up here for Thomas Samoilovo. The Finnish coach of Russia is a change-up at the middle blocker position, with the experienced Dmitry Shcherbinin coming in at the expense of the two-time VNL gold medal winner, Igor Filipov. Other than that, it's pretty much what we expected from the Russians. Time to meet Japan, and led out by their captain Masahiro Yanagida, who keeps his place in the starting lineup. He'll be followed out by a switch up here for Japan as well, with now Nobu Fujii getting the start at setter. That's an interesting change up. Nishida and Ishikawa. The big hitters outside, Kentaro Takahashi and Taishi Onodera. And starters for Yuichi Nakagaichi. Also changes things up at libero as well, bringing Taichiro Koga into his lineup. So the interesting switch up here is the switch up at setter. Masahiro Sakita, the regular setter, on the bench today after now Nobu Fujii came in off the bench last night and looked really good in a 3-0 blanking of Australia. So both coaches shuffling the deck a little bit. It's the best of five sets. Win a set, you're going to get to 25 points, but you must win it by two clear points. How will Japan cope with these big Russian blockers? How will the Russian big beasts cope with the energy and the defensive prowess of the Japanese? Ishikawa can't find a winner there. And a block comes in, but nothing doing. The block could not get any control on that one. So it's Russia on the board, first of all, courtesy of their veteran Pavel Kruglov, the only 2011 World Champ, World Cup winner still on this squad. Here is Yakovlev, who's not only a huge blocker, he's a big ace server as well. That's not one of his big ones. Nishida's got nothing to do there. No play at all. This is a shaky start, this. But the Japan start team that always come out fast. So a block point early here for the Russians. Two very, very tentative starts. This is not the start they wanted at all. You know what? Yuichi Nakagaichi, I think, has called a halt to this already. Well, they've missed a block, Japan. They've had a block come back against them. And now they've had an ace serve. Philippe Blaine, he's the technical wizard, the assistant coach. He's the in-game guy, the guy who makes all the little adjustments. I don't think he expected to be making adjustments this early. That was just a straightforward case of you guys need to wake up. Very, very slow start here. Yakovlev has got plenty of blocks in him, but he's also got plenty of aces in him. Japan know that for certain now. Russia off to a flyer here. When you're taking a timeout after 3 points, it's not good. And it's been a really poor start by the hosts. Yakovlev then will look to just pour it on. Japan needs side out just to settle down here. Yakovlev serving in silence. That's a better take. And Ishikawa then gets blocked out of it again. They're in big trouble with this block already. That was Shcherbinin getting in there. Kruglov alongside him, but that's why they brought in the veteran Shcherbinin. I think Kruglov gets the touch, and indeed he does. with Sherbin bolted in alongside him. That's the block working in harmony. So two block points and an ace in 4 points against Japan already. Kana started this match much worse. As Yakovlev then will stay on serve. He's always got an ace up his sleeve. Yanagida picks that one up. Nishida gets blocked and it's dropped on the line. It's another one. Podlezhnik, I think, celebrated that one. Well, absolutely horrendous this for Japan. They knew they were going to be up against it with blocking. And I tell you what, another big change already. Fujii's out of there, the setter. Sakita comes back in after that nightmare start. Not all Fujii's fault at all, but they've got to change it up. 5 points on the board, three of them stuffed blocks from the Russians. Yakovlev finally lets one go long. Japan finally get on the board. But those first two swings, they look nervous, they look tense. There's no mystery going into this one. All these big physical Russian blockers were always going to be a handful for Japan. Well, they've virtually tossed away this first set in the first 5 points. Nishida with a sizzling serve that is well taken. Now, can they regroup here? Ishikawa goes up against the block, which sends it back. Sakita goes for the quick inside set. And Takahashi drills that one. That's how you got to deal with the block. Get the quick inside stuff going before the block can set. Those outside guys are going to have trouble tonight. So common sense says take it inside when you can. Another important take. This going, if it's a duel in the net, Japan won't win it. Russia look for the reset, and there's a quick inside take. Sherbin drills that one, taking it very high. And the angle big Sherbin took was absolutely no chance of a comeback. Serve well. They have been serving well, Russia, with some terrific service reception earlier. That's got away there. That's got to be a nice take, and it is all the inside. Spike that pick. And then Nishida can't get a winner. The containing block was there. They'll reset, retool. Voronkov couldn't find a winner. No play available at all there for Yanagida. Nishida, lovely cross-court pickup, but it's gone. They're defending really well, Russia. They're making Japan win a point, not once, not twice, but three times. Takahashi. It's a nice one. It's an ace. Drilled and fed off Voronkov. Couldn't deal with that at all. That's a bonus. Takahashi really unloading on that one. Straight. Sent like an arrow straight at Voronkov. Lots of flight on that ball. If you misjudge that by a couple of centimeters, it's going to fly off at a weird angle. Well, an ace helps Japan just get back a little bit closer. Settle down now after that horrendous start. Be interesting to see how they deal with the block going forward. Voronkov has dealt with that one a lot better. And he put away, he's not there. Nishida's picked that up. Yanagida's got a lot of work to do. Oh, that's brilliant. Absolute brilliant down the line. Oh, that was tough to get a winner from there. Masahiro Yanagida facing those powerful blockers Manages to rub one off the block. Still dropping in play anyway. Shcherbinin couldn't quite stop it. So, it's Dmitry Shcherbinin. Now the Russians are going to win most of those duels at the net. They don't want to be seeing stuff at the net. At the net, the happier they'll be. Shcherbinin with another one of those whippy serves of his, taken high by Nadira, but picked up. Wonderful rescue there from Koga. Nagina runs one off the block and away. He's working really hard here. Which back captain conjures up another point. Haven't shaken Japan off after that awful start. Japan are still tucked in here, looking for a couple of points back on serve. Too good. Once again. Vorokov rifles that one away off the block. Terrific effort from Nishida. Serve in. Hard attack. Doesn't work. Comes back on second touch. Now Japan can reset here. Nishida wraps one off the block. Pick up there from Ishikawa. Bandera. Yes, these are the quick ones. They've adjusted really well. And, a lot of this will be down to Philippe Blaine, the in-game adjuster. Well, they've seen just how devastating that early Russian block was. Just finding ways to neutralize it. Madeira with serve, that's an easy one. That's going to get buried. The setter didn't even have to move. Oh, this is perfect, just look at that. Just have to stand there. Sergei Grankin could just hang it up there. Now here is Ivan Yakovlev. Japan had nightmares with his serve early in this set. They're still chasing Japan here. If they give up another point on serve, I think it's going to be too much for them to pull back, so they've got to get rid of Yakovlev. Got to be side out here. Backside to Nishida, and that's beautiful. This is what they've got to do. You take on the Russian blockers, power for power. Japan are going to lose. They've got to be clever with it. A little bit of finesse, take everything off. Just a little dink. In control of this first set, but they haven't put it away. Japan have regrouped really well. Oh, that's brilliant. Oh, Pavel Kubrov has found the line. Oh, that's a vicious ace, and this is the problem when you're chasing. It only takes one moment like that to make the job borderline impossible. Kubrov has delivered a beauty. It had speed, it had swerve, it had spin, it had accuracy, and there's no way that was coming back. Big ace then from Big Pavel. He goes for the very high ball toss. Nice take from Ishikawa. Sakita has made a bit of a mess of that. We'll get a second bite at it with Ishikawa. The containing block is there. Now where will Sakita go? Pipe attack. Nice. Yanagida ripping through from the back court. Drilled that one. There he is lurking and lurking. They see him coming. He sends it away from the block. They're not taking the block on anymore. Oh, could be an ace there, Annie's. That's gone. That's gone. Ishikawa cancels out that earlier Kubrov ace. That's ace for ace. So we're back where we were. Look at that. Anton Karpukov, the libero, activated for this match. Not giving up on that. I thought that was Andreev, excuse me. 16, not 6. Turning high hurdler there. Ishikawa drills another one. Nice pickup. Oh, but sent long. Sent long. Oh, Kubrov with the miss. They'll challenge this. Block touch is what they're looking for. I thought there's no way this is an in-out challenge. Thomas Samelvo, I think as much as anything, has just decided to use this instead of a timeout just to break momentum. And if there is a touch there, that's a bonus as well. This. Oh, what a beauty again from Ishikawa. Podlezhnik blocked out of it as well. They are back level. Takahashi read this all the way. Timed his jump perfectly and sent that back. And Russia do now call a timeout at 14-14. Different look to this first set now. They've adjusted so well, Japan. haven't been blocked out of those first few points. Look at what they've done since. Well, we've got a technical timeout coming when the leading team reaches 16 points, but Thomas Sualvoa decided he can't wait for that. There's been a big momentum shift in this one, the longer it's gone on. And Japan have adjusted to the Russian strength absolutely brilliantly here. Serving's got to be good, and it has been. Ishikawa now will look to keep the pressure on. Really nice take this time. Podlezhnik manages to find a cross-court kill off the back end of it as well. Really good take. Russia keeping the initiative here. Japan needs a side out just to stay level. All sorts of conversations going on here. Yeah, the Russian players and their coaching staff. Abramov wasn't happy about something. So who can push on from here? It will be Kentaro Takahashi to serve. 16-15 Japan. Not the best take. The block's there, but it's only a containing block. Grankin will send it far side, and that is taken off at least two would-be blockers by Fedor Voronkov, who's absolutely drilled that one. Side out Russia. They stay level. Yakovlev comes back in, the master blocker, back at the front of the net for Russia. Sakita sets up Nishida. There's no winner there. Krugloff, brilliant. Koga does a nice job as well. Nishida has another go, gets blocked out of it. Guess who? Guess who? Ivan Yakovlev. They can't take him on like that on the outside and expect to get consistent winners. These Russian blockers, him in particular, are just too good. They see it, they read it, they react. Sherbin in. Beautifully done. Sakita then. 17-all. Oh, he's nailed it! He's nailed it! Oh, what a sizzler! Well, it looked like it had gone too long, and then suddenly it just swerved and dipped absolutely brilliantly. Look at this. That's gone, that's gone. Oh, and then it slammed the brakes on. Dropped in. That absolutely bamboozled the Russian backcourt. They didn't see it coming. Well, whatever. Sakita found there. He needs to find another one. Japan keeping the pressure on here. Sakita takes everything off that one, floats it in. It's an easy pickup. Krugloff driving in, sends that one back with interest, side out. That'll send Grandkin back to the service line. Well, this is what Japan want. Russia dragged into a side-out battle here. Yanagida, clever. And there's a chance here. That's Krugloff. Does take him one off the block there. Krugloff operating at a very high level of efficiency in this match. Keeps finding winners. There's another one. Rankin stays on serve then. Oh, the half attack. Ishikawa just about got away with this. Your heart's in your mouth. Look at that. Three of them converging. Not enough momentum on that ball to bring it back over the net. Rode their luck a little bit there, Japan. Yanagida then looking to serve here. 19-all. It's a beauty, absolute beauty. Grankin stretching, and then the block comes back. The big block from Taishi Odadira. That's all about the quality of the serve, though. A lot of servers wouldn't have even got a touch on this in the first place. That's brilliant from Grankin. But it was always asking a lot of Yakovlev to get a winner from there. The block could take all day, the setup. Odadira, all he had to do was time his jump for an easy stuff block. And Japan keep the pressure on. Now, can they make a breakthrough here deep in this first set? Yanagida looks for Andreas, picked that up beautifully. That's coming off the block and away from Yakovlev. Off the quick set, side out. Still, we can't separate them. Real tempo to this first set. Yakovlev ripping the cover off the ball there. Voronkov. Going for a ripper as well. Koga's done well. Ishikawa. Oh, my goodness me. That's the cross court of the match so far. Oh, watch this. Just watch this. The block, gone. The cross court defenders, three of them. Nobody moved. Can't hit it any better than that. Onodera then. The 21-20. Still, they keep the pressure on. They're the front runners. Russia have to side out to keep pace. The next Japan point on serve could be a set-winning point. Does it come here on the Onodera serve? Oh, it's not the best take. And Voronkov has missed it. That's because he had to take it so low. Now, hang on. Well, that's got to be challenged. I thought he just missed it. And I didn't see a call not overturn that, but obviously they did change their minds on the floor that took a touch. If it did take a touch, it's side out. If it didn't, Japan have got this first set where they want it. And he absolutely had to call this one here. Yuichi Nakagaichi. This is a big moment. Anything there? Can't see anything there. Nishida. It's not got him. Well, the original call looked good. And then they overturned it. Thank goodness for the challenge system. Now, Japan have a lead. And Thomas Sualvo has to say, whoa, we've got to think about this. If it's a side-out battle from here, Japan win the set. Side out from here on the Onodera serve. Got to deal with this. Cool glove. Picks up another one. Known for his handsome, rugged good looks, Pavel Krugloff. Bit of a pin-up back in his native Russia. And he's not thinking about his rugged good looks here. He's just thinking about the cross-court put away. Beautifully taken by Mr. Handsome. Now they've got to pull this back. Yakovlev's the man for a crisis. Dangerous server. There's no danger there. Just to the cameraman behind the advertising hoardings. That's the last thing Russia needed there. It takes Japan another point closer to securing this first set. Yuji Nishida there. Generally doesn't hold back on his serves. Let's see what he comes up with here. There's another whipper. Gone. A serve. Set point, Japan. Oh, this really was a ripper. Well, that's what Russia needed from Yakovlev on the last serve, and he sent it way too long. And then Nishida comes up with that. The teenage terror strikes again. And Japan on the brink of completing a terrific turnaround here. Think how badly this match started for them. They adjusted, they adapted, and now Nishida will look to wrap up this first set. Misses by a whisker. By a whisker. But Russia need 2 points on the Krugloff serve. The first one doesn't challenge. Nishida driving and wraps it up. Beautiful deep kill into the backcourt. Well, who would have expected this 25 minutes ago, when Japan started so badly, 3 stuffed block points against them, but they steadied the ship. That early timeout taken by Yuichi Nakagaichi and Philippe Blain, absolutely the right thing to do. Japan settled, regrouped, adapted, and started playing to their strengths. That's why they've secured this opening set, 25-22. But now it's the Russians that are going to try to adapt. Let's have a look at the numbers. They've survived giving up five block points. The four aces have been a big difference maker. Sakita's was an absolute gem. And they've started to get some big hits getting involved as well. Spreading the load. Nishida leading the way, but Ishikawa, Yanagida and Takahashi inside also contributing. If they can just limit the damage done on the blocks against, Japan will fancy that they can go on and win this one. And that Russian blocking, such a weapon. Long, long way to go. You always want to be the team leading off with the first set. Put the pressure on the other guys. Japan have done that. It's up to Russia to show us how they can regroup here. Somewhere the Russians are probably still thinking, how did we lose that first set? All those early stuck blocks. I have to forget about that. Start of this set then. That's not a good take at all from Bolesznik. He just has to hoist and hope here. Japan with a great chance to put 2 points on the board, and they take it inside Takahashi. That's really shaky from Yaroslav Podlezhnik. Thomas Suelvo, I'm sure, will be looking and maybe making some changes. That maybe is a definite. Anton Semyshev is coming in, and it's Podlezhnik that's going out. No surprise to see that happen. Start from Semyshev either. Can he finish the job? That's going to get picked up. Tough take this. Yeah, that's not happening. to rescue that situation, didn't they? So, a poor start from Russia in this set, but it was Japan who started the first set very poorly. It's not how you start, it's how you finish. Yakovlev, who has a block and an ace already to his name, serves Taichiro Koga. That's ripped off the block by Nishida. So, hugely happy about all this. Semishev with a waggle of the finger there, as if to say, this needs to get looked at. A net touch is the call. Well, if that's coming from a player, as he saw it was, there's every chance that he's seen something. Sometimes the coaching staff see the net and they're not sure what's happened. But if a player sees the net move, very often they've seen exactly why. So this one might not work Japan's way. And they're absolutely right. A stray hand from Kentaro Takahashi. That's all it's taken. Well, Semishev with great eyes there. It's a mental mistake from Kentaro Takahashi. On such very, very small points do sets and indeed matches hang. Yakovlev then will continue. Nishikawa is not exactly perfect with his take. He gets blocked. He'll have another go. Gets blocked again. But they managed to keep it in place. Akita goes backside. Nishida does not get blocked. Yeah, a couple of the giants there. Semishev and Sherbinin were there. And a little teenager ripped through it there. And just glancing it off Semishev. And away. He's brave as a lion. He'll take on the biggest blockers out there. Yuji Nishida. Oh, goodness me, what a sizzler. Andreev's done really well. That's all about the quality of Yevgeny Andreev. Picking that one up, yeah. They all looked at him. All the big dogs on the Russian side looked at their libero and said, well, we know who that's on. That's on you. Never mind that Fedor Voronkov had the easy put away. That was all on service reception. Mr. Handsome up serving next. Pavel Kruglov. Of the dashing and debonair good looks. Ishikawa denied by Voronkov. And they're scrambling around here, Ishikawa. More scrambling going on. Voronkov's kept that alive, hoisted over somehow by Grankin. That was brilliant. And then finally, somebody takes control. That somebody being Kentaro Takahashi. He takes this one off the block. Wonderful digging, both sides of the net. And in the end, before the blockers could get set, Takahashi sent it on its way. Real tempo to this match. The rule seems to be when the Japanese are on court. That's an absolutely beautiful take. One of those that a world-class setter like Sergei Grankin makes it look so easy. It really wasn't. What a take. Sherbinin puts it away to finish the job. But the set was absolutely beautiful. Semishev, the new man in. Sends over a sizzler. Koga picks that up. Yanagida. Just as good enough for Japan. They love it. This wasn't far away from another stuck block. Look at that. Japan looking to keep the pressure on here. Takahashi. The only person that was troubled by that was Thomas Zameldo, the Russian coach, who had to take evasive action. That was so wide. Sherbinin then will go for the serve. Oh, really going after Koga at the moment. That was gone. Oh, a really quick take from Onodera. Bit of football from the Russians. Almost looked like he was bringing this back. But no. Away watched it go, safe in the knowledge the map was gone. So Japan keeping the foot down here. Sakita, can he find another ace like he found in the first set? Nope. Nothing doing there. Boom. Fedor Voronkov with the get that back swing. Every so often these come up, don't they? When you're an outside hitter and you can say, I can just swing through this and demolish it. And that was one of those for Voronkov. The block is almost apologetic in trying to get there. Sakita goes inside again. That's Andreev sending that back brilliantly. Sakita will look to go for the pike attack. Ishikawa is denied. Nice containment from the Russians. And that's not going to be contained, is it? Pavel Kruglov swings through on the cross court. And Russia edging their way in front here. That's a lovely cross court winner. Rankin then. Ooh, Ishikawa's made a real mess of that. Well, goodness only knows how Nishida's done that. It's hoist and hope. They'll just have to hope for a mistake here in Japan. And they get a block. Shoving each other out of the way here. Now they can transition. The block comes back. What a point. The pipe attack. And that drops in. That's an absolutely brilliantly played point. Voronkov sends that back. Both teams at full stretch. This is absolutely brilliant from Nishida. Goodness only knows how they kept that alive. Then they had a chance to win the point, but they didn't get it. A stuck block comes in, and Russia jump in front here. And the first technical timeout. If they're blocking, they're winning. Setting the pace early. And the Russians have responded really well. A very good Russian squad. This is not a bunch of second stringers here. There's another block attempt comes in. Nishida will have to have another go, and he's forced to send that way wide. That's the quality of the block there, and nothing more. He was thinking about it, thinking, how does he get through? Side set. Look at this. Yanagida. This is getting out of control here. A couple of misses. And Japan have to take a timeout off the back of that last one.
We have to find. Take the time for this reception. You will do one more time, sir. With you on this position. What do you call?
Hey, come on. If you have to work out to stay on there. Narak. Take it to me, both of them. Take it to me, both of them. Okay. Possibly.
Say,
big lead the Russians have got here. And Grankin will stay on serve. Back-to-back misses from Japan, necessitating the timeout. Serve spun up in the air by Semyshev, but managed to contain that. And Ishikawa, who had to adjust, found the winning lesson. That's nice. That's nice. That's what they needed. So it'll be Yanagida serving. Continue his comeback and ends with a net serve. That wasn't far away from sneaking over. We'll bring Voronkov up to serve. Just missed. Now hang on. Is that going to get a challenge? They called it out on the floor, but it was ruled good in the chair. And it's not being challenged. So Japan, no, that was a good call in the chair. Overruling there. More reinforcements. Tatsuya Fukuzawa coming in. Captain Yanagida sitting down. Voronkov will be looking for another one, like the last one. Russia back in control of this second set. Bonadira. Some work to do here, Japan. Looking for 3 points on serve. You're likely to get one here, you would think. Well, it's coming back. They've got a second go at this. Russia isn't coming back. That's Pavel Krugla will rip it through that one. Big time cross-court kill there from Krugla. They send Yakovlev back to the service line, which is never good news for the receiving team. but digging in. Semichev. Just misses. Well. We're at the second technical timeout here. Russia looking good now.
Кнопка мы ставим прямо, прямо, окей. Если ударить через кнопку, там у нас есть диагональный зацит за ее линию. Сейчас пока, возможно, что концовки угадаем чуть-чуть больше туда, окей. Вижу Куку Саба, он тоже, вот обычно нет, он бьет, есть кинка в линию. Перевозона чуть-чуть ближе, линия закрыта, принесу. Давай, давай, давай.
Semichev comes up with an ace. Nishikawa with a miscue. Ishikawa and Nishida rather getting in each other's way there. Now Issei Otake will come in along with the return of Naonobu Fujii, who was sacrificed right at the start of this match. The setter, Sakita, will check out Otake. A strong defensive player has also got quite a swing on him as well. Fujii sends that over, and Fukuzawa sends it on its way off the block. Take from Semichev, he's been very solid since he's come in. There must have been some contact there. Indeed, there was. Japan clawing their way back into this. Got a lot of work to do, and they're going to do it quickly. Got half a chance here. He knows it's so important that Russia hang on to this set. She serve is well taken, and he's not going to be stopped. That is Pavlov driving in at speed. That wasn't going to get picked up by anybody. Absolutely ripped it past the block and down the line and gone. And Russia stay in control. Here in set two, Sherbinin. Will serve. Oh, that's not a great take. Not a great take at all from Ishikawa. Well, an easy put back there for Ivan Yakovlev. This is what you've got to do on these overpasses. They've got to come back straight away. Oh, Yakovlev got the finger going there. But don't bring it here, finger. I see another change up here. Ishikawa will check out. That's a big, big win for Russia right there as Naoya Takano will come in. So Nishikawa, Nishida and Ishikawa, the two big hitters for Japan, currently on the bench. More or less an admission for Japan that they're not coming back into this set. Atake sends that cross court in there. Rankin trying a bit of fancy footwork to keep it alive. He's a decent server. They need an ace from somewhere. Yeah, Otake was looking to get a bite of that baseline, wasn't he? Yuichi Nakagaichi knows that this is going to take something very, very special to come back from this. Oh, that were a Russian meltdown. And the Russians are very strong mentally. Grankin with serve. Very happily silent for Russia. Very happily. Zawa drills that one, but Russia with this healthy 4-point lead here, no. But unless they make a monumental mess of this, the second set is going to be theirs. Lovely take by Semyshev, who's going to be rock solid on service reception, and then Baranka finishes the job far side as well. That's a really nice side out for Russia, who are looking ominously good here. Grankin with the easiest job in the world, didn't even have to move, didn't adjust, just sent it backside. Baranka can't really miss from there. He'll now go back to serve here at 21-16. Otake, no, that's not a winner. Oh, that's a rare break down there, a double touch. Called on Andreev. Some former Samuel Duro must know. It's highly unlikely that Japan are coming back from here. Unless Taichi Onodera can come up with some big serving, which would be an unexpected source of huge serves. He's not a devastating server. Semyshev's hung that up in the air. They've got it in trouble's way. Oh, my goodness. Oh. Oh, Grankin and Semyshev ran into each other there. He's thinking about a timeout. He's thinking. So Melbourne has decided he's going to call it. Has to. It's not a crisis. Far from it. They've still got plenty the breathing space here, but you don't like to see things like that on the court. Tell us a lot. If Russia side out, should be back to normal. If Japan pick up a point here, they will be getting sweaty arms on the other side of the court. If Japan are going to get into this set, I've got a feeling this is the moment that they have to make their move on Adira then. With another flat serve, Semyshev picks that up. It's back to doing what they do so well. Russia, very well taken timeout by Samelvo. You always just want to settle everybody back down after you see a mental breakdown like that. Just remind everybody of their responsibilities. Yakovlev. Watching, waiting. Driving through there is Takano. Nothing doing there. Otake. That's doing for the big hitting. Issei Otake. Side out. The longer Japan can keep Russia out there here, the more resting up Nishida and Ishikawa can be doing in the bullpen. They're all going to sit back and watch and wait. As the second stringers here look to just try and take some of the energy out of Russia. That's a pretty good take. Rankin ripped that over. It's a Krugloff who will demolish the cross court. That is a demolition job. Pavel Krugloff destroyed that one. Andrei Surmachevsky will come in now, who is quite a server. You're bringing in him at 23-19. It's the equivalent of bringing in a closer to pitch in baseball. You're just trying to wrap it up right here. He's the guy that they call on when they really need something from the service line. So let's see what Surmachevsky can conjure up here at 23-19. Goes big. Just misses. Just misses. They're going to challenge that, I think, because that was close. That was close. It was a typical Surmachevsky serve as well. He absolutely demolishes them. And it has missed. But that didn't miss by much. So he'll go back out. As Krugloff comes back in. Japan running out of chances here. Ishikawa comes back in. It's last chance time. A big Ishikawa serve here. Maybe they can get the Russians rattled. That's a good one. Really well taken. And locked off the block. That's all about Fedor Voronkov in the backcourt of his take. That's perfect. Absolutely perfect. The rest is easy. Sherman and drop one off the block. Set point Russia. Not many times with Japan in this World Cup been forced beyond three sets. They're going to be here, despite that long one. Close, Semishev. But Japan need 3 points in a row here, they're not going to get it. Haku Lee will come in. Lee brings something different with his serves. He can make this ball move. And Russia, I think Thomas Samelnoy just wants to remind his players of that. Lee does bring a different look with his serve. Interesting in this set, it's been a much sounder all-round game. Blocking hasn't been the story. They've been running away with block point after block point. They've just played much better, much more grounded all-round volleyball. They've just got to deal with the Haku Lee serve here. That one's flighted away there. Andreev got right underneath it. The push. And that'll do it. Well, a big sense of anticlimax here. They were ready to raise the roof, these Japanese fans. But the Russians have been ruthless in that second set. Only once before have Japan been taken into a fourth set in this World Cup. Argentina winning the third set there before Japan went back and wrapped it up 3-1. But it's definitely going to be at least four here because the Russians are level. Look good doing it. Well, the numbers make interesting reading, don't they? Look at that, attack points level, blocks level. It's the quality of their serving. And has been the difference maker there for Russia. They really are mixing it up very nicely. Semyshev coming in has really just helped solidify things. But it's no coincidence that he's sent down a couple of aces since he's come on as well. So Russia had to react, and they did. They adjusted very well, so both teams have adjusted to each other. It becomes a best of three now, with each team having secured a set. Who can push on from here? Good news for Russia, the bad news for Japan is when play resumes, as it will be momentarily, it's Ivan Yakovlev who's up first in the rotation for Russia. One of their better servers. As the reigning VNL champions want to jump out to an early start here in set three. Ishikawa are the new guard of the big hitters for Japan. Fukuzawa at 33 isn't going anywhere. A huge part of this Japanese offensive juggernaut. Speaking of the new guard, though, here's the 19-year-old Nishida. Ripping that one. Really nice take there from Baronkov. Oh, that's come back with interest. It's Takahashi. Just demolished that one, didn't he? Here he comes, Semyshev. Not sure if Takahashi got anything on it or whether he was just there. He was there, but he'll celebrate like he's got the block. But that was nothing but nylon. That was all net cord. Semyshev, I think, saw Takahashi looming and ended up swinging into the net. Nishida then will send another one. Oh, that's nice. That's spun away from Baronkov. That's some force. That's gone five rows deep into the crowd. This is the biggest one. I mean, the movement on that. That's going to be an ace against anybody. And it's poor old Baronkov that's in the firing line there. I'm not sure there's many players in the world would have handled that much better. So, Japan letting rip early here. Russian either side out, getting Ishida out of there. He's got some fire there. That was too much fire. That'll bring up Pavel Kruglov. His job's done, certainly, Ishida. Ripping some serves there to put some early pressure on the Russians. Kruglov looked to put some pressure back. Ishikawa takes that. That's a nice rub off the block there from Kentaro Takahashi for an immediate side out. Sammy Chef was there. Couldn't get it in play. The longer this match has gone on, in fact, really from the first technical timeout of the first set, Japan have dealt with the Russian block very well. Up until then, the block have been dominating them, but they really have settled. Fukuzawa got too much on that. That was never going to slam the brakes on. Anton Semyshev, the youngster, who was a valuable member of the Russian squad that just won VNL gold. An emerging talent for the Russians. He just misses the sideline as well. Takahashi. That's going to go as well. Oh, these are freebies. Everybody's sending them either wide or long at the moment. Let's see if that streak will end here with Dmitry Shcherbinin. Very powerful blocker, Shcherbinin. He's also got a big serve, way too big. So that's four in a row, two each. With a flow way off course, Shcherbinin trudges into the bullpen. As the libero comes back, we'll wait and see if Shcherbinin comes back. He didn't look very happy going back into the bullpen there, did he? Little floater comes in there. Oh, lovely pick up from Koga, but he couldn't get underneath it. Lovely cross-court winner there from Voronkov. Need to find some rhythm. Grankin puts some pressure on with his serve, which is a real sneaky floater. Ishida gets blocked, but they've managed to keep it alive. Ishikawa the other side. Brilliant from Andreev. What a dig from him. Around the block, but nothing doing. Kruglov wins that battle. And Russia now building up some momentum. This one a lot better. Ishikawa doesn't get a winner. Yes, he does. Even though Yakovlev got underneath it, really lost where he was. Now that we've got a Russian player down here at the moment. We'll just look at this replay. Yeah, he landed pretty heavily there, Voronkov. He's just not getting up. He is up now, but it looks like he is going to continue. Definitely got dinged there, but getting the head cleared. Volleyball players are tough. Ishikawa then. Lovely pick up from Andreev. Grankin has to move though. And there's a block there to take out Kruglov. We'll have another go here. A swing through that. That's going to get collected. And Ishikawa gets blocked. They read it. Yakovlev. They've got to be smarter than this, Japan. These big hitters trying to send it down the middle against these giant Russian blockers are always going to risk that. Had to finesse it there, Ishikawa. Now that's not wise after the event. Yakovlev, his eyes got very big when he saw Ishikawa coming through there. He was ready for it, and he took him out. Koga was a bit off balance there. Nishida gets blocked. Back-to-back blocks. Not a deal. got one in the face there as well. Just to add insult to injury. Watch number 20 there. Boom. Yeah. Oh, that's going to sting. Oh, Japan wobbling again. That lead is gone. Voronkov goes for the floated serve. Japan will get another look at this. Nishida gets blocked again. So, his third set, tightly contested in the first technical timeout.
The second one was better because you saw between. First one you see down. This one. Start in the middle to protect a little bit the short serve. Because you see that they want to serve. But this one is fine. So, if middle can help. Then. So we've got 8-7 after the technical timeout. Set 3 here amongst the Russians. Rankin sends that backside. Kubiak rips that one. Sometimes they're just not going to come back. This was one of those. Kubiak leading the way for Russia. In terms of point scoring, he and Nishida for Japan, the only players in double figures. And actually, Ishikawa, by his standards, really quiet today. Just half a dozen points here in this third set. Just sent a little bit too long, and Yakovlev looking frustrated there because he's always a danger. Japan very happy to see that one go. And now Russia won't be too happy to see who's at serve. On the other side of the net, because it's young Yuji Nishida. And we know what chaos he can cause. Wonderful pickup from Semyshev. Couldn't have done it much better. He'll get third touch as well, but they'll get this under control. Sekita will set the backside, and he's blocked out of it. Nishida coming through, just took him on. Straight lines again. They're going to get gobbled up. No finesse, no attempt to disguise anything. And the veteran, Dmitry Shcherbinin, who's been there, seen it and done it, read that one all the way and said, don't bring it here. Or if you do, you better bring a bit of finesse with you. No finesse there at all. Kruglov with serve. Nice take, Ishikawa. That's come back somehow off Nishida. That one is still alive, unbelievably. This is great work from the Russians. They can't do it a third time, though. Takahashi, they stayed on the front foot there. Japan, that was the key there. Even though Russia was sending it back with a bit of good luck and some brilliant reflexes, they could never transition. Japan kept on scrambling and eventually found the put away. Stay in front here, keeping the pressure on. As Fukuzawa, he can be a creative server.
He'll look to conjure something up, and he sends the sneaky one in. Rankin will set that up, and Kugloff will send one over that's too hot. Koga got underneath it, but it was never dropping in play. And a comfortable side out. Semyshev, 10-10, set 3. Absolutely nothing between these two teams at all. Oh my goodness me, that one cleared the advertising hoardings, it cleared the camera crews, but it didn't stop till it went into the crowd. That is officially the longest one of the day. That was at least 12 metres beyond the service line. The baseline, excuse me, there from Semyshev. Takahashi, much better pickup. Semyshev, the block. The block is there. I think that was Ishikawa taking that one. Well, that's a big moment right here. In comes Kruglov. Onodera was there, but so too was Ishikawa, and I think that's all his. Well, he's had a tough time with his attacking, Ishikawa, but that'll boost his morale. It just didn't drop the right side of the net, though. That's a shame, just when everybody thought that was a winner. No, it wasn't. Nor was that. And Shcherbinin. Well, that was so close for Ishikawa. Shcherbinin went the wrong side of the net. An earlier point. Nice move in the arena. Well, that was a stuffed block. It wasn't. Sekita. Nice serve. Absolutely buried by Yakovlev. Well, he didn't have much of a block to deal with, admittedly, but this had some real spite on it, that swing. You don't want to be getting in Ivan Yakovlev's way when he's in the mood, and he seems to be in the mood right now. But that's clever. Ishikawa then. Scramble, Rankin hoists it, was shunted over by Kruglov. Chance here for Japan, really good chance. Ishikawa ripping in, that'll do it. Japan making the breakthrough here. Midway through this third set, bit of breathing room, something to work with. And there's another one that just won't go back over the net. This time it's the Russians that can't send it back. Frustration for Pavel Kruglov. Delight for Ishikawa, he's had to fight for everything in this match. Let's see what he can do from the service line. Semyshev with a perfect take. Oh, and he's over, he's sent it too far. I don't think you can believe that. Well, nobody's perfect. They are not machines. But you would have backed Ivan Yakovlev 99 times out of 100 in that situation. There's the one in 100. And that opens this up. Now Japan with a bit of space. Ishikawa, nothing but nylon there, side out. And the Russians are chasing a couple of points here. Voronkov, looking to pull one of those points back right here. Not a challenging serve. Ishikawa gets right up and he back to shoot. He rips across court. That's what he's got to do, mix it up. No chance of a block getting set there. This is the way to take your team into a technical timeout. Clean kill, cross court. Semyshev watches it go by and says, where was everybody? Nobody could pick that up. 16-13, then set 3.
Waiting for a five or left to right. Right to pick up from the shirt, guys. It's on the shirt, or head, or gap.
あの真ん中のパイプが張ってる。パイプが両サイド。
They stay like this. So short sides are.
Zonadira then serving. Semyshev with the take. Kuklov can't get a winner out of that. Now, can Fukuzawa come to something? He's pushed it a little bit too deep. There's a good chance here for the Russians. Kuklov pushes it very effectively. Much needed side out for the Russians. Yeah, well played point there. Kuklov adds another point to his collection. Yeah, Kuklov would serve. That's trouble. It was all about the overpass. Nishikawa in the back door there. Put his hands up as soon as that went back. There he goes, says, yeah, that's on me. Sorry, guys. Which is all you can do. And it comes back like that. Straight down the middle as well. You know it's going to get gobbled up. So one of those points they need has come back here, and it's on the Yakovlev serve. Among those swooning at that one. Kuklov does have him swooning back in his home country, apparently, but not with serves like that. Fukuzawa then at 18-16 from Japan. Buy themselves a bit more breathing room. Grankin sends that down the middle. Nothing doing. The push from Ishikawa. Oh, there's a whistle that goes against the Russians. Japan have got a bit of breathing room.
Okay. После сил у нас будет Андрей нападать, а у кого-то... будет высокий мяч, окей? Помни, каждый линию закрыта, играй много за суть. Давай!
Давай!
Japan in a good place here after Russian timeout. So here's Fukuzawa. Not a challenging serve, the Park attack. That's coming back though. Sherbin denied. Sherbin will have another goal and gets it right at the second bite. Well, Sherbin in fact with the fake on that occasion. Sneaking in behind him, Baronkov with the put away. They had to respect the fake though. Sumachevsky, the ace server, picked up off the floor by Koga, and it's somehow got back. Japan will have to send it back again. Ishikawa! But no, that's hit the floor. That hit the floor for certain. Baronkov doing everything he can for the pancake. He wants to challenge, and I think they're going to challenge. They're going to challenge. That's called a floor touch. Sometimes the player that gets the pancake will get the hand underneath, but it'll hit the floor as well. Now, Samelvuo will be hoping that's not the case here. It did look like it caught the floor, but there's definitely some fingers under there as well. Enough to keep it off the floor. Let's have a look. No, that's definitely the floor. That's the floor all the way. That's what it looked like in real time as well. Well, that was an interesting point, wasn't it? See a switch up here. Sobachevsky will come back out to Savishev, but the switch up on the other side sees Haku Lee come back in for Takahashi into the position of the service line. Oh, that's not a good take from Andreev at all. Once again, Lee's serving, causing problems. Ishikawa can't get a winner out of it. Nishida won't make a play either, so the Russians should be able to transition here. And Kuglov rips it. That's a missed opportunity. A real missed opportunity there for Japan. So Lee will come out. And it was his serving again that nearly produced a problem. And Dmitry Kovalev will come in here for Sherbinin. So they bring a pinch hitter in as well. The Russians. All getting sweaty palm time at the business end of this third set. Let's see what Kovalev can come up with. A double VNL gold medal winner. Ishikawa gets the medal of the block there. Rankin and Yakovlev were there. Ishikawa is out of work for everything. Comes up with a winner there. So Kovalev will check back out as the Russians go back to their base. Now, Masahiro Sakita conjured up a beauty of an ace in the first set. Can he find another one here? Not going to happen there, is it? Now the block has contained it. Sakita goes backside. Nishida finds a win. This set now completely controlled by Japan. All about the containing block there. And Nishida had to get this one right. takes it early. There's a little gap there, just enough before Yakovlev could get over there and lock up with Voronkov. He's managed to squeeze it through there. Samelmaro calls timeout, but it's going to take something special to drag this set back from the brink. Setter, Rankin, nicely taken by Ishikawa, and Nishida rips it inside out. They're going to bring Issei Otake in here as well to try and get a bit more presence at the net here, with Nishida checking out. They can get a block point here. Well, pretty much home and hosed here, Japan. And the Ishikawa serve, 23-19. They're nearly there as it is. So, Otake will check back out again. Russia keep this going here? It's a beauty of a serve from Baronkov, picked off the floor, and then Nishida puts it away to take Japan to set point and a 2-1 lead here. That was a wonderful pickup here. That's a wonderful moment for Ishikawa defensively. Brilliant. Skimmer. Krugloff will make him wait. No, he won't. That's been rescued, and then it is put back by Krugloff. Had to win it twice to keep Russia alive. But they need 2 points on serve here. Japan look to grind out this third set. What a good match this has been. Nothing has come easy on either side. Well, this is the man you want at the service line. Ivan Yakovlev. When you need 2 points. Ooh, he's almost got one there. Ishikawa's just been underneath it. Nishida finds the winner. Japan go 2-1 up here, and the place goes crazy. Well, pats on the back there. Rightly so for Yuji Nishida, but two superb takes of serve from Yuki Ishikawa. Really helped Japan get over the line there in a very hard fought set. All three of these sets have been nail biters in their own different way. This really a late night treat in Hiroshima for the 7,000 or 8,000 that are in this arena. They are loving it. Japan a bit of breathing room as well. This was hard fought. Still the blocking is a problem for Japan, but they're finding a way to win despite the blocks coming at them. Have a look at the attack zones for Japan. It's a very balanced spread. They're keeping those Russians moving around the net, not letting them get comfortable. It is Nishida leading the way with some help. Oh, Russia have to come from behind again. Don't be surprised if they do it. Don't be at all surprised if this one goes into a nail-biting fifth set. Start off with Ishikawa. full set underway with a long serve from Yuki Ishikawa. Sayo, he's looking at that as if to say, oh, come on, did he catch the line? But no, he really didn't. Here's Yakovlev. He's done a nice job of containing his serving. He hasn't managed to wreak too much havoc. A couple of blocks as well from the big number nine. Just avoided taking him on. There's another ace now. He's always got one lurking. Ishikawa's lost that. Ishikawa's having a bit of an up and down with his service reception. That was one of the downs. That's why they keep going after him. He's done pretty well, particularly at the back end of that last set. And obviously Russia feel there are things that they can exploit there. And Yakovlev certainly made the breakthrough there. After Ishikawa again, much better take. Nishida, though, can't get a cross-court winner. Yakovlev. Oh, my goodness, did that take anything on the way through? No, it did not. It's just a swing and a massive miss from Serbachevsky. Well, he's the guy that's normally brought in for his serving. Oh, that was a wild one. Bonadira then. Japan chasing early here. And they're still chasing. Chasing in vain. It's not coming back. Well, that's a key to say, well, I got underneath it, but that's a very, very forlorn hope. Challenge there. Well, it was whistled dead, and Sakita saying, well, no, I got the pancake under that. Even though he did, Ishikawa following up had no play. So if this call goes their way, they're very, very lucky here in Japan. It's not even a floater, is it, that one? That's not going to happen. Got thrown out. Rightly so. Point goes to Russia. Kruglov with serve. Nishida's in trouble, and his son managed to conjure something up out of that. That was unpromising, to say the least. There were a lot of defenders over there, and he decided, no, I'm not going to go for the big swing here. Serbachevsky trying to push it back. And got beaten again. Sizzler from Nishida, beautifully handled. What a pickup from Koga. And can they make anything out of this? Back they come again, and another miss. It's a big miss from Serbachevsky. Oh, that's two in a row he's missed. Well, he knows this could easily be 5-1 from the Samoa. Instead, have settled it back down again. We are level again, and Nishida is still at the service line, sending in the big ones. Just too big. We're going to wrap this up at four. Russia looking to take it to the tiebreaker. Now this is where Andriy Serbachevsky does all his best work at the service line. So Japan will be looking for an immediate side out here. Oh, beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Can't serve it much better than this. Absolutely nothing to say. That is just too good. It's a serious weapon, this Serbachevsky serve. Good to see that one go wrong. Fukuzawa then. I think what happened there was Ilya Vlasov moved across. Yeah, there we go. goes. And I don't think Zobachevsky could see that. Literally lost the flight of the ball there because Vlasov got in front of him. It's a big breakdown for the Russians. That was a nothing special serve as well. And was that from Fukuzawa? It's completely bamboozled Zobachevsky, who's having a nightmare out there at the moment. Not all of his making. He might have got the ace serve, but he's completely overhit a couple of swings. Now he's been done twice in a row on service reception. Thomas Samalvuo is resisting the temptation to change things up. No timeout, no substitutions. He's leaving Zobachevsky in there. Fukuzawa will go for him again. That's better, much better. But the block's there. Absolutely wonderful turn of events here for Japan. Well, service reception was much better, but Vlasov was wiped out by Takahashi. Oh. The two new players for Russia, Vlasov and Zobachevsky, in their own way, are having a torrid time out there in Japan. And Fukuzawa look to turn it up a bit more. It's going to go and go and go. And we've got a Japan player on the floor getting up slowly. That's young Nishida down there. Just take one in the face there. And when a volleyball player stays down, that means they're hurt. Everybody knows it. Really cool when there's Sakita, not Nishida. Cool one full in the face. Should be okay. It's easy to say from up here. We just haven't been blasted by 110 kilometers. A swing. Yeah, Fedor Voronkov was over there just to offer the hand of friendship. It certainly wasn't personal, it certainly wasn't intentional. Peter's okay, he'll have a black eye and a bruise in the morning. And he'll wear that with pride if Japan get the win here. Ilya Vlasov looking to level it up. Koga's got underneath that a little bit. This is a tough take for Nishida. Oh, what about that? Well, they'll keep it alive, but it's hoist and hope time. And Japan have got to make hay here. Where's Sakita going to go? Pipe attack. That'll do. Off the block. This is getting challenged. Hold your horses. Well, get out is the call. This might be interesting. It's just middle of the line. Japan clawing their way to the first technical timeout. Another absolutely gripping set unfolding here. It's been a really good match.
I mean, it will stop between them, so if you make one step in this direction and you let this one.
Okay. He stays here.
So we can make it. Oh, okay. And for the number 9? No. Or he takes the position long. And if he protects this one, did you take the rest? Or you want to take a long?
No, I go shorter.
So you protect this one long. Okay.
Longer? No. Yeah. Mike, there, but it's okay. Mike, there, like this. It's not like this.
いや、俺が前行く。俺が前上がるから。こういう感じで。いや、前だったら無理だ。俺、こういう先行後ろ。引き込みインサイド。これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ、これ
Well, by the narrowest of margins, Japan maintain their lead here. Once again, this one looks like it's going to be fought for every inch of the way. Takahashi with serve. Taken by Andreev. Drilled. Kept alive. Nishida. Now, there's a whistle there, and it's gone against the Russians. Voronkov puts his hand up there. He must have really had a lapse. Yeah, he's just gone in, hasn't he? Gone in. Well, even after that rescue, it was all unnecessary because of the contact of the net. So Japan get the point. They get a bit more breathing room. And it keeps Takahashi at the service line. Nice take. Yes. It was important there for Andrei Silvachevsky to handle service reception well, and he did. And was also dispatched with interest by Ivan Yakovlev. Side out, Russia chasing a couple of points here early. Their veteran captain, Sergei Grankin. Olympic gold medal winner with serve. Ishikawa, no, nothing doing. This is going to be a tough take. Really tough take. You have to admire the fact that Voronkov went aggressive when a lot of players would have just played contained there. And he says, yeah, that's on me, but I tell you, that wasn't far away from being a stunning winner. When you're a set down and chasing the fourth, is it necessarily wise to play contained? You've got to play aggressive. Voronkov so close to coming up with something very special there. He could do it. It's Akita. He'll come up to serve now. For Japan. Where's that going? Voronkov's not handled that brilliantly. This is a tough take. Yeah, no real play there for Kruglov. Real play here. What a play here for Tatsuya Fukuzawa. Ripping that one down Main Street. Well, this is so well played. He had blockers there, and he shredded them. A tiny, tiny gap between Voronkov and Yakovlev. That's all he needed. He's ripped it through. Now, they're in trouble now. Sam Alboa calls time out. Sakita to stay on serve then. Ooh, that was a zinger. That's coming back. That is sent back with interest as well. Well, once again, Silvachevsky's had a nightmare on service reception. Come over on first touch. He's really struggling. Not surprisingly, he is being withdrawn. Podlezhnik, who had his own problems with service reception earlier in the match, comes back in. Japan have built a very, very strong platform here to go on and wrap this up in four. Sakita goes after the new player, Podlezhnik, who handles that. Kruglov blocked out of it, absolutely wiped out by Onodera. That was a tired-looking swing as well from Pavel Kruglov. This is going to take an awful lot of coming, bringing back. This is a big, big gap that's opened up here. Sakita, who's mixing up his serves, finally nets. A much much needed side out, but Russia needing 5 points on serve here. The only good bit of news for them is they've got quite a bit of time to work with. Voronkov will start to try and claw some of that back right here. Ishikawa with a sizzler, but Lezhnik has struggled. And then manages to take him off the block to effect side out. He may have struggled, but he got enough underneath him to keep it alive. Wonderful, wonderful bit of setting there from Granken. So Russia continue to chase these 5 points. Yakovlev. The one they've got to watch. Ishikawa watched it all the way. Sakita with a lot of time. That's picked up. Now they push back over. They've kept this alive, Russia. Sakita will send it far side. Fukuzawa will drill it across court. That one's not coming back. Voronkov did a great job first time. Could not get a piece of this at all. That's a wonderful pickup. Great defensive scrambling. Krugloff playing his part as well. But all in vain. A big gap there between the blockers, and Fukuzawa drilled it through. Japan keeping the pressure on here. Well, can Onodera take them into the second technical timeout with an unassailable lead? Lezhnik with the push. Krugloff is blocked, but that's going to have to sign out. Krugloff now will serve at 10-15. Nice take by Fukuzawa. Nishida ripping through there with a lovely bit of rescue work from Voronkov. But Lezhnik goes for the push. That's enough. There's one of those points back. Koga gets under that nicely. Pipe attack. Ishikawa rips that through and side out. Japan with a 5-point lead in the second technical timeout. Still a very, very good squad out on court right now. Nishida. Well, it's an ace. It's a beauty. But Lejnik just helped it on its way. Service reception. Once again, causing all sorts of problems for the Russians. They've just never been steady and settled back there. And Nishida rips another one. That'll be his fourth. The match's top scorer as well. We'll look for another one here. Oh, I think he's got another one. Yes, he has. Well, he had Podlezhnik and Voronkov going for that. That's what you want to do with yourself. Get two of them going for it. If you get two of them going for it, you end up with nobody getting it. Back-to-back aces. And surely this set and this match is done. Thomas Samelbo calls timeout. All he can do. There's no way back from this. Absolutely devastating serving. Just pulling away those back-to-back aces. They're already in a very, very comfortable position for Japan. But they've made this an almost unassailable lead. Under normal circumstances, Japan should just go on and finish the job here and secure a fifth win out of seven. It's the teams they've lost to that make it hard for them to get onto the podium, though. Poland and the United States have beaten them in straight sets, and they still have to play Brazil. Nevertheless, Japan just keep winning and see how far it can take them. Even if it's a side out here, Russia needs 6 points on serve now, which is what they're going to start to try and claw back. No hat-trick of aces then for Yuji Nishida. Just two there. To the tally, five in the match for him. Yaroslav Podlezhnik will now look to serve up a few aces of his own. Won't get any there. Fukuzawa, who's been serving pretty well himself. A lot of variety in Fukuzawa's work. Floats one over there. Podlezhnik takes that pretty comfortably. Oh, that's still alive. It's still going. Oh, my goodness me. Voronkov just has to push. Now they can transition. Here comes Ishikawa. Well, they had it covered. Voronkov eventually rips one. That was much harder work than it needed to be for Russia. But they do get the point. Switch things up with Dmitry Kovalev coming back in. As Grankin checks out, switch up of setter as Ilya Vlasov drops back. Still Russia needing 6 points on serve here. Koga's got that right. Yeah. The rest of it was a case of joining up the dots. Koga just hung it up there. Sakita just pushed it up. Kentaro Takahashi put it away. Haku Lee will come in, along with Issei Otake. They're looking for a block here. They're looking for a little bit of creativity from Haku Lee on serve. And Lee is a very creative server indeed. 20-13. Surely this one's out of sight already, but Lee will look to just pile the pressure on. It's most un-Haku Lee-like. Doesn't matter. Japan don't need points on serve at the moment. So they'll go back to their base. Kovalev then. Serve. It's a pretty soft one. Got exactly what he deserved. He should have a great one down the line. Well, if they want to get back into this, they're going to have to be so much more aggressive on their serves, Russia. That, of course, comes with a high risk of net serves and long serves, but if you play it safe, that's what's going to come back to you. So Japan, 4 points from wrapping this one up. Masahiro Sakita with serve. Just died on Andrea, but he did manage to get underneath it, and that took a touch on the way through. Side out. Voronkov. But you can't blame Fedor Voronkov for going for the big one. As we've already seen, you play it safe, might as well give the point away. So Japan side outing to the winning post here. Ishikawa. No, they're not. They're going to go out with a bang. Ishikawa just sets in another ace. They must be close to double-digit ace serves today. Must be close. Yoshida's got five on his own. Ishikawa tacks one onto the collection. That'll be his second. And mixes it up nicely. Podlezhnik collects. Kuglov. Too good. Kuglov has led the way for the Russians. That'll confirm a 20-point match for him. But it's going to be in a losing cause, and just as well Masahiro Sakita stopped there, because if Sakita had taken on the camera would have won. Russia just about done here. Two match points. No problem. Drops one into the net, tried to be sneaky with it, it didn't come off. Everybody's on their feet. Japan on the brink of securing another very impressive win. What a goal with an ace! It had to be an ace, didn't it? Oh, wonderful, wonderful start from Japan. How impressive was that? They've done it again. Well, the first three sets were tight, cagey affairs. They blew this fourth set wide open. Russia wilting in the face of sustained ace serving and very big hitting. Yuichi Nakagaichi has seen his squad add another big scalp to the collection. They've beaten Italy in straight sets. They've beaten Argentina in four. Now they've beaten a good Russia squad in four. That is five wins. Egypt to come tomorrow, they'll have their eye on six, which will at the very least guarantee them a winning record at this World Cup. The improvement continues. Maybe Japan not quite at the level of the big hitters like Brazil and Poland and the United States and a full strength Russia, a full strength Italy, but they are closing that gap. We're seeing that. John Spurrier, the American coach, was talking about it. He said probably over the last 12 months there is no more improved team in world volleyball than this team right here. Once again, the crowd has helped them on their way. And Japan overcame the shakiest of starts here, giving up those early block points. So the first half a dozen points, you thought, well, they're in big trouble here. It didn't turn out that way. They adapted beautifully, and look at that Russia in that last set. Didn't even get a block. They live by the block, but they couldn't carry on blocking throughout this match. Japan adapted so well, and their serve just got better and better and better. Six aces in that fourth set, as Russia just got blown off the court. The overall numbers look like this, 12 aces in the end. Russia got 10 blocks, so many of those came early. Three in the first half, a dozen points. And an even 50 attack points for Japan. Nishida leading the way, he got blocked out early. But he adjusted and adapted so well.